Do you like these little bottles? I got them at the dollar store so that I would seem more witchy. Hello friends, Tara here, but you can call me T Pow. And in this week's video, I'm going to be making crystal infused perfume. Now, I'm not sure how long the idea of crystal infused perfume has been a thing, but I do know who popularized the idea of mixing crystal with perfume. Kim K herself. In November of 2017, three perfumes were released by KKW Fragrance, and each one was inspired by a different type of quartz crystal. According to Kim, she wanted to share the healing properties of crystals with her fans because she had received multiple healing crystals from friends and family after the robbery in Paris. Remember that? Nowhere on the website or in any of the research I did does it say that these perfumes are actually infused with the properties of the crystals. In fact, the only crystal thing about them is the shape of the bottle and the names. But unlike KKW Fragrance, there are tons of brands out there that actually put crystals directly into the perfume. Another way that crystals are incorporated into perfume is making the rollerball out of crystal so that the perfume and the crystal both touch your skin. But today, I'm going to be making my own crystal-infused perfume using the former method, which means I'm going to be putting actual crystals into my perfume bottles. If you believe in the healing and energetic properties of crystals, which I'm assuming you're at least intrigued by if you clicked on this video, by including crystals in a perfume, you're essentially making an elixir that is infused with the properties of those crystals. And people have been anointing crystals with oil for ages, so the idea isn't really new. We've just decided to make it a bit more bougie. And even if you don't believe that crystals are anything more than glorified rocks, you can't really deny they look really pretty in perfume. So the main idea behind this is that when combined with essential oils, the properties of crystals can be enhanced. For example, lavender essential oil is often used for anxiety and stress relief, and so is the crystal amethyst. So if you combine those together, they should enhance each other. So let's get started. So unlike most of my crystals and my necklace, which are usually like a larger piece of a crystal, these are tiny pieces of crystal, which is usually called crystal chips. I just needed something small enough that would fit in these little rollerball bottles. And I put them in these little glass jars, not only because it's cute, these are from the dollar store, by the way, but because I actually put them on my windowsill during the last full moon so that they could be charged. But something very important to remember if you decide to do this yourself is that these crystals are going to be living in oil in your perfume. So you need them to be above a 5 on the Mohs hardness scale. Remember that from like 5th grade science class? So as you can see, all of the crystals I'm using today are 5 or more on the Mohs hardness scale. But if the crystal you choose is below a 5 on the Mohs hardness scale and you leave it in oil, it will slowly dissolve, and that is not good. So I'm going to link a video in the description that explains this better than I could, so more of an expert on the subject. So to enhance the properties of the crystals, I am going to be using essential oils, and this is also going to give the perfume its fragrance. And even though a lot of certain types of companies, MLMs, will make you believe that you can put essential oil directly on your skin, it's actually not recommended to do so. You always want to dilute essential oils in some other kind of oil or water before applying it to your skin. The main ingredient in our perfume will be this oil, our carrier oil, which for me is going to be fractionated coconut oil. Fractionated coconut oil is just coconut oil that has been processed in such a way that keeps it a liquid at room temperature, because as you may know, or you remember from my DIY beauty treatment video, coconut oil is actually a solid at room temperature, so we don't want that. We want a liquid. That's why I'm using fractionated coconut oil. That's important. But the main reason I chose this as our carrier oil is because it is completely clear. And obviously, we want to use a clear oil as opposed to something like sweet almond oil or avocado oil that's a little yellowish in color, because when we put our oil in our rollerball bottles, we want to be able to clearly see the crystals inside, because that's what makes it look really pretty. So since I already used it as an example, the first combination I'm starting with is amethyst and lavender. So first I'm going to add the crystals to the bottle. Now, not all of these little chips are going to fit because they're a little too wide for the bottle opening. So I'm just choosing the ones that will fit through the top, and I'll find a different use for the ones that don't. Some properties of amethyst are that amethyst can still the mind and help you enter a meditative state. It alleviates sadness, grief, stress, and anxiety. Amethyst can also protect from other people's low vibrational energy, so I have a feeling I'll probably be wearing this one at work a lot. So I filled about a quarter to a third of the bottle with crystal, and now I'm gonna add my essential oil. And I'm adding about 10 drops of each essential oil to the bottle. And next I'm just gonna fill the rest of the bottle with the fractionated coconut oil. And as we learned 2 weeks ago, the best way to do that is with a dropper and not a funnel. So the specific oil I chose is French lavender. And the scent of lavender will not only rejuvenate and inspire a tired person, but can relax, soothe, and slow down someone who is stressed or tense. Lavender is beneficial for relaxation and is often used as a natural sleep aid. A lot of people will spray the scent of lavender on their pillow, or they'll have lavender-scented candles to fall asleep, or even lavender-scented incense. And now I'll just put on my rollerball. And there it is, our first crystal-infused perfume made with lavender and amethyst. And this one is going to be my stress relief perfume as well as my protection from all of the low vibrational energy at my job. This next perfume is going to be my confidence booster, and I'm making it with rose quartz. These are without a doubt the tiniest chips that I purchased, so I'm being really careful with these. So it's gonna take a little bit more to get a quarter of the bottle full. I might just end up pouring them straight in from the bottle. So I chose rose quartz for this perfume because rose quartz is used to expand the energy of confidence and self-acceptance. Rose quartz is the ideal crystal for developing gentleness, love, and compassion towards yourself. Self-love was harder for me when I was younger, and I still cared about what people thought of me way more than I do now. However, I still struggle with it from time to time, so I thought this would be a good perfume to have in my arsenal. The essential oil I'm using is jasmine. It smells so pretty and floral. This was actually my first time smelling it because I didn't choose it based on how it smells. I actually chose it based on its properties. It can help you to have positive feelings of self-confidence and can aid in emotional healing, which all contributes to self-love, so I thought it would be perfect to combine with rose quartz. And now I'm just filling the rest of the bottle with our coconut oil. So here's my confidence booster perfume with the rose quartz inside. This is gonna smell so good. My next perfume is going to aid in good fortune, and for that I'm using green aventurine. People think that just having this crystal, green aventurine, makes you somehow luckier. But what it really does, it helps you to have a quote, attitude of gratitude that helps you to see the little blessings in your life. And when you feel more gratitude, you can manifest a positive life more easily. I accidentally filled this one a little bit more than the others, but I'm gonna leave it that way because I have an expensive wedding to pay for next year, and I wouldn't mind a little good fortune. I'll be pairing my green aventurine with Lang Lang oil. Lang Lang oil can assist in making decisions from the heart and bestowing the courage to live one's truth openly and proudly without worry of judgment. I don't know about you, but fortune doesn't usually come from being lucky in my experience. It comes from understanding the right decisions to make and then being in acceptance with those decisions after you make them. in that you made the right decision. And if you feel that you've made the right choices in life, you probably feel like your life is going the way it should, which means that you're going to have more gratitude about it and you're going to be able to manifest better things in the future. And that's why I paired those two together. And this is my Good Fortune perfume with Green Aventurine and Lang Lang Oil. And for my final single crystal perfume for positive vibes and creativity, I saved my favorite crystal for last, Yellow Citrine. Citrine has mood-boosting power. It attracts the negative energies into its aura and transmutes them into positive, joyful energies once more. Citrine is the perfect tool to cleanse and rejuvenate your spirit. Citrine is a crystal replete with creative energy. I love citrine because it's all about positivity and creativity. My introduction into crystals was through Ayurveda, and citrine was one of the first crystals I ever bought for myself, and it's been my favorite ever since. The essential oil I'm pairing with citrine is blood orange because it is stimulating and spicy, which is great for elevating mood and cognition. Now, I didn't realize that blood orange essential oil would not be clear, but luckily it's yellow, which will pair just fine with the citrine. It's kind of, as Bob Ross would say, a happy accident, and I don't think it looks that bad, especially because as I add the coconut oil, that yellow is going to be diluted further, and it'll still be clear enough to see my crystals. So here is my positive vibes and creativity perfume. Yes, it is colored yellow from the blood orange. I don't think it looks ugly. I think it just reminds me of the perfumes that used to sit on my mom's dresser, and that makes it a little comforting. All right, so now we're really gonna have some fun and we're gonna start combining crystals. So our first combination is going to be for deeper self-love, and I'm going to use amethyst and rose quartz. Let's start with amethyst because that's a bit bigger. I'm choosing the most purple ones I can find because a lot of these are just kind of more clear than others. So I really want the purple to show through if I'm going to combine the two. Amethyst is associated with the third eye and crown chakras, both of which are chakras that help you connect with your highest self and aid in spiritual exploration and enlightenment. And rose quartz is often known as the crystal of unconditional love. It has a gentle feminine energy and promotes compassion, peace, and comfort in yourself. It has the ability to help you realize your true worth, to let go and release deep emotional wounds, and allow you to open up and give and receive love from others. That's kind of a big thing when you don't love yourself. You feel that you're not worthy of love from others. So when you do feel that you love yourself, you can more openly accept that love that others would like to give you. So here's how they look combined. The little rose quartz crystals have kind of covered the amethyst, but once they're suspended in the oil, they will move a bit slower and we'll see them easier. The oil I've chosen is bergamot. First of all, it smells so good just on its own. Bergamot is literally known as the oil of self-acceptance, which makes it a perfect pair for the rose quartz. It is said to relieve feelings of self-judgment and low self-esteem, which makes it a great oil for the third chakra, which makes it tie in well with the amethyst, and together everything is just a big promotion of self-love, deeper self-love than the rose quartz on its own. So here is my oil for deeper self-love. The bergamot did have a little bit of a tint to it, but nothing as extreme as the blood orange. Here's them side by side to compare. As long as I can still see the crystals inside, I'm good. So I have one perfume left, and for this one I'm really going crazy and I'm combining two crystals and two essential oils. But it's very fitting because this perfume is about maximum life force energy, and that will be brought to us by Citrine and Green Aventurine. Now, I didn't just choose to combine these because they rhyme. Citrine carries the power of the sun. It is warm and comforting, energizing, and life-giving. It stimulates the chakras, clears the mind, and stirs the soul to action. As I said before, Aventurine helps to find hope and joy in life, and it also helped you to embrace change and growth. Now, the two oils I'm using are grapefruit and eucalyptus. I'm going to put way more eucalyptus than grapefruit because grapefruit does have a yellow tint like blood orange. I checked it first this time, but eucalyptus stimulates the brain and improves your energy, so that one is self-explanatory. And grapefruit is also known for boosting energy. So everything I've put in this bottle is meant to increase your energy, your creativity, your fortune, your gratitude with life. It's just positivity, happiness, and zest of life in a bottle, and I think that is really fun. All right, and that's my final perfume for maximum life force energy. This is another one I think I might need at work because it's hard to stay positive there. I'm gonna put that one on right now before we do this outro. So, for those of you who don't believe in healing properties of crystals or essential oils, this might as well be snake oil. Because if you don't believe that it's doing anything for you, then first of all, it probably won't. But even if you believe that this does nothing as far as healing or has no energy, it's still perfume that smells nice and looks pretty on your dresser at the end of the day. So if you're someone who wants to introduce crystals to your friends or your family, this could be a good way to do it because you're not just handing them what they would perceive as essentially a rock. You're giving them something useful that smells nice and looks pretty. But on that note, these would make a great gift. They're super easy and quick to put together. Each one probably took under 2 minutes to put together. The time-consuming part of the process was actually looking up the properties of the crystals and the oils, but that's actually the fun part because that's the part that makes these not just a regular perfume, but a perfume that actually serves a purpose of some kind. If you have a favorite crystal, a favorite essential oil, or even a favorite crystal essential oil combination, please let me know in the comments down below. And if you try this, please let me know, or even send me a picture or tag me on Instagram at Miss Teapow. I would love to see what you come up with. And if you're new here, please don't forget to subscribe. And as always, thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you next time.